Hello everyone, today we're going to doodle. I don't know what we're going to doodle, so we'll just doodle. Spring onion. Yeah. Let's do a spring onion. I might have started. It needs to be smaller. It's too big. And then it's got like some little roots. I really should organize my brushes better. Okay, spring onions. Are kind of like this color at the bottom. And then they start going greener. We'll just give it like the base coat. Like it's underwear. This color is its underwear. Every painting needs its underwear. Without the underwear, it's just naked, right? Am I wrong? We'll fade that down a little like that. And then we need to go more towards bluey greeny tone. Fade that in a little. Maybe bring it down a little bit like that. And then let's go a little greener but darker for the shadows. We'll do this in a separate layer in case I hate it. Yeah, I can work with that. Let's do a little bit more of this color. For the shadow. And then separation. I can't tell which is going where now. Okay, let's do a little like that, and then a little bit like that. Some little veinies. I don't like the veinies. Getting rid of the veinies. Too much veinies. Um, That's a lower level one. And this one's kind of in behind that one, I think. We'll go separately like that. And then this is behind these, so we need to drop a shadow there. And then we'll go back to this color, and let's add some highlights on top. This part right here isn't working for me. It's something's off. Maybe we need to separate it a bit more. That looks better. Want a little bit more of a yellow tone towards the tips. Nice. Cool, it's looking good. Then we need roots. The roots are kind of like, I don't know, they're like a weird color. And then let's drag that down a bit more like that. And then spring onion. Hey, spring onion. Maybe I should outline this just a little bit. No, I don't like that. No outline. Let's drop that down. Delete that, and then, we don't delete that. We delete that. And then, we'll put a cute little, backing to it, maybe. How would that look? I like the muted color. We'll go with the muted color. And then we'll do a little shadow. Something like that. There we go. Spring onion. Yay. Let's move spring onion up over here, and then we'll do something else. Let's do, what goes with spring onion? Hmm. I don't know what goes good with spring onion besides food. I'm googling vegetables. What kind of vegetables we got? Let's do a carrot. Yeah, let's do a carrot. We're gonna do a carrot. I wanna do a carrot. Alright, let's see. A carrot. Do this kind of shape. Should we do a funny carrot? Maybe we should do a funny carrot. I found a carrot that looked like it had legs, something like this one time. And I felt bad about eating it. Yeah, we'll do that. And then they got little leafies. Wait, what does carrot top leaves look like? Hold on. Carrot. Oh, okay. Okay. So, it pretty much just looks like a fern on top. Cool. Just little leafy leaves. Leafy leaves. Something like that. Maybe we'll have some leafy leaves come out over here too. Yeah, that's a good start for it. Alright, back to paint. Let's do the orange part first. Putting on its underwear. Putting on its underwear. Underwear is on. Now we need the shadow of the underwear. The contour. The contrast. Give it a three-dimensional feel. I'll clean it up after. And then let's give it a little bit more of a golden hue. And go on top. Yeah. Yeah, let's do a little cleanup real quick. Erasers. Now, we need to do its stripey stripes. Something like that color. Let's do Something like that, and then we should do some highlight on top. So it kind of pops. I'm listening to music right now and they just gave me a commercial for diarrhea. They're trying to say something. Diarrhea. I can use more shadow along the bottom side. Then we'll take our blendy blend and just kind of feather that out some. There we go, that looks a little better. And then we need to do the same for its little side foot. Just like that. And then... there we go, that pops a little better. I think it needs more up at the top though, like right in here. And then do the little blendy blend so it's not like harsh. Now we can move on to the leaves, the green leaves. They're kind of like more of a bluey green hue. We'll start off with that color. Then we'll move it more to that for the highlight. Yeah, something like that. And then we need the leafy leaves. Can I do a simple one? No. That doesn't work very well with the tablet brush. What if we do this one? Can we do this one? No, that's too bunchy. What about this? Do this one. It's not really what I'm wanting. Maybe we'll just do it ourselves. But this one? Oh, no. We'll just do it ourselves. Little greeny leafies. Little squiggles. Let me hide this sketch so I'm not getting confused and I can see what I'm doing. And then we'll go over the top. That was some little highlights. Ankeny is a little more of a yellowy tone. Yeah. Then we'll clean this up. And then we get to do the background. What would go good with a carrot? How would brown look? Like a rich brown. Oh, that kind of makes the green pop. Yeah, there we go. That works. And then little shadow. And it will be called carrot. We have a carrot and spring onion. Let's do an eggplant. I haven't done an eggplant before. So the eggplant rough shape is something like oblongish, and then it narrows out at the top. I don't really care for eggplant as a food. It just, it always tastes really bitter and weird. Something like that, and they have like a little cap at the top. Something like that, I think. It's good enough for me. I'll be able to sell it to an eggplant, and that's the whole point. Eggplants are kind of like a kind of like in that shade, I guess. Kind of like me. Maybe I'm secretly an eggplant in disguise. Could be an eggplant. And then they kind of have like a burgundy-ish kind of undertone. So we'll give it like a little burgundy coloration here and there and blend that in. Especially like in the dark. They're also shiny. Oh, they're shiny. And let's do a little bit more of a purpley hue on top of that for blending. And then kind of like a faded for the shiny. The shiny, shiny, the shiny, shiny. Let's blend that and see how it looks so far. I need to put it on bottom later. Mixing. We need the darker color for shading. Maybe right around here. Maybe a little dot right there. In there. In there. It looks convincing as a grapefruit. This color here needs to come around, though. Let's add some more shade over here, too. And more of that burgundy color. Like that. Does it look like a grapefruit? Kind of. I guess. It works for me. It'll clean up. Now let's do the green top. I feel like it should be more muted. Aren't they more muted kind of color for their greenies? Kind of. I probably should looked at the eggplant better. Well, it's drawing from memory. It definitely needs more shading, that's for sure. I don't like the shape of that. Ah, that looks good. Yeah, that looks good. Good, good, good. Good as enough for Renekton to me. Well, I got messy with this one. Yeah, there we go. And then we need a background for it. What background color would go good with grape? Or eggplant? Grape. Let's try this color. Make it's the shadow color. Yeah. Egg plant. Eggplant. So we got an eggplant. We got a carrot. Let's rotate eggplant. It's beautiful. Spring onion, carrot. And eggplant. Maybe we could do some like cherry tomatoes down here. Yes, do some cherry tomatoes. Cherry tomatoes. Let's do one here. Maybe one in the back like that, and then one in the front. And one to the side. Yeah. Should we do them with the leaves or like how you get them in a container at the store? Let's do them with their little leaves. Wait, what does cherry tomato leaves look like? I think they're kind of like, shaped like a star. Kind of like that. Yeah. Okay. Now for their color. They're like bright red. Super bright red. Yeah, that looks like a tomato color. And then for their darker color. Wait. Direction of light. I have everything coming kind of down at this angle, so we'll follow that pattern. And then their highlights kind of more of a, like that. Now for blend. Looks nice. I think it needs a little dark thingy here. Maybe we'll make it darker so I can actually. It might help if I actually use the brush. Okay. There we go. And then for its greeny top. Maybe that green. Then we'll do its little leaf piece. Get rid of the sketch. I don't like how this one sticks out, so we're just gonna. There we go. And we'll add some shadow to the leaf area. Like that. And then we'll clean this up. Just a touch. Cute little cherry tomatoes. And then for the background, tomatoes. Maybe we could just do like a nice greeny yellow. I don't like that. Maybe. No, because then the leaves blend in. What if we do kind of this color? No. This color? Yeah, that kind of looks okay. There we go. Now what could I draw? We could draw a Brussels sprouts. I like Brussels sprouts. We'll do the Brussels sprouts right here. They're kind of like little mini cabbages. Sure. They're usually like that. No. Maybe we should just do one. Or switch the position a little more. Yeah. And they're kind of like the wrap kind of like that. Let's start with this color for them. Let's drop the opacity so I can see where the lines are. It's more pale than that, though, isn't it? Like, they get pretty pale pretty fast. This looks like a hot mess. Let me put the line art on top so that I can see better. Okay, that looks a little better. We need more light colors, I think. Like that. Placeholders. What is this one? Let's go ahead and put some more greens to blend that with. Like that. Yeah, maybe. I don't know. I've never painted a Brussels sprout before. I need to separate them. So, since that comes in this direction, maybe. And then the ends are kind of like yellowy, aren't they? Yeah. We'll put them like that. Huh. Is it kind of looks like a Brussels sprout? Maybe. I don't know. What background goes good with that? Brussels sprouts.
Brussels sprouts.
Yeah, from a distance it looks better. Look at that. Yeah, they're kind of cute. Okay. Yeah, that kind of makes them pop a little more veggies. Ta-da! Thanks for watching. If you like the video, then comment, subscribe, and all that good jazz. Thank you. Bye bye.
Ha ha ha.